today's session is very important. I will try to, in a minute, give little brief about what it is intended for. But before giving that brief, I will request each one of you, starting from Dr. Umesh Shukla, to please introduce yourself to the audience. Dr. Umesh Shukla.
This is Dr. Umesh Shukla. I am Principal and Chief Executive Officer of Pandit Khushilal Sharma Government Ayurveda Institute, Bhopal. And I'm MD and PhD in Ayurvedic Medicine. And others are my colleague, Dr. Vivek. You can introduce yourself.
Myself, Dr. Vivek Kumar Sharma, presently working as lecturer in the Department of Kaya Chikitsa, which is Internal Medicine. I have done my BMS and MD in Kaya Chikitsa Department.
Okay, great. Yes, please. Dr. Dwivedi?
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. I will be using for work. Sanjay, sir.
Okay.
Hello. I am Dr. Sanjay Srivastava. MD Kaya Chikitsa, Nursing Professor, and HOD, Department of Iran, the Diagnostic and the Superintendent, Pandit Khushilal Sharma Ayurved College, Bhopal.
Okay, thank you very much, and I will request you that all of you can please switch off your microphone, and whenever you wish to speak, you can switch it on. That will avoid this echo which we are facing at the moment. So I request you to kindly switch off your microphone, which is available right on your icon, whatever device you are using. At the bottom, those icons are available, so you can switch off your microphone. That will help in a better quality of the sound we can maintain. And I once again welcome Dr. Umesh Shukla, Dr. Bebe Sharma, Dr. Sanjay Srivastava, and Dr. Dwivedi. And I think one more is expected. He will join soon. So today's session is more exploratory in nature. As you understand that I am a national and global president of Crime-Free Bharat, and it is having 18 Bharat in it. And one of the Bharat is Healthy, Wealthy Bharat, Chemical-Free Bharat. And so how really our Ayurvedic knowledge, Vedic knowledge could be taken to the, especially in the rural areas, and ensuring the well-being and health and wealth for everyone. And while doing so, how we can use technology for doing so. First of all, we have to understand that Indian value system has gone to docks. And basically, we have lost our ethical values. You must be wondering what I really intend to say. Say, we are, whatever the milk we are consuming, we are only producing 1/3 of the milk. 2/3 of the milk is of the chemical origin, which is carcinogenic in nature. Our vegetable, our fruits, nothing are pure. Lot of chemical, not only form of the fertilizer and pesticide is being pumped in, but lot of money even administered through the injections. Bags and other harmful things are being pasted or being used to give a better color. Even the colors are being used to give them the fresh look. Now we are even facing another extreme where eatables are being made from the plastic material and probably we are not in position to even differentiate that whether they are a genuine product or they are being made of the plastic material. That kind of the differentiation is not possible. We are having rice which is artificially made. I don't know whether you are aware or not, there was one factory which was raided by the police in Dewas district. That factory was supposed to manufacture or sell Shuddh Desi Ghee. And on police raid, it was found that there was not even a trace of Shuddh Ghee. So they were manufacturing Shuddh Ghee by using chemicals and by using different smells, scents and things like that, and creating a product which was very close to Shuddh Ghee. I don't know whether you have seen, there was one session in NDTV, and they did that about that milk. And they went to the milk dairy, and they went to the person, those who artificially produce milk. They took the sample from both. And it is very unfortunate that milk sample, which was basically created through the chemical material, it met all standard of a good milk. It means the people at the receiving end, they would not be in position to differentiate to a larger extent whether it is a artificially chemically prepared milk or whether it is a genuine milk. In this era of all fraud, people want to earn money from whatever the way it is possible. In this era, ensuring the pure and good medicine itself a challenge. We are having one forest institute which is manufacturing some medicines, and they conduct scientific tests to compare whether the product which is being given to them, whether it is genuine or not. And they are using the computer driven software to really find out, because they are also facing the problem, the so-called the innocent tribals. They are bringing the stuff which is looking to the like that medicine, but it is not the medicine. So our bigger challenge is, number one, before the knowledge is lost, lot of research must have been done. Charak Sangita is also a collection of the wisdom and knowledge of different things, and especially medicines. Now it is a high time that we can work and add and identify medicinal plants which are orally available, the new medicinal plant which may be part of some tribal culture or some other culture which are not the part of the Charak Sangita, if those could be further added. And then we can really think of if we can use these products not only for the treatment but for the healthy living. It means each one of us would be requiring some element, some medicine, and as a part of our healthy living. Can we calculate how much medicine could be made available to each one of them? Because at this moment of the time, we will not go whether the person would be in afford to have that. We will not go into the dimension how this medicine will reach to that those person. Those tools we will be designing little later. Let's presume that everybody is having the resources, or if they are not having the resources, government or anybody else can commit that whatever the amount of the medicinal plants, medicinal consumption they are requiring, we will make it sure that it should reach them. So if it reaches them, then to a great extent, it will serve our purpose, right? Now, do we have enough plants within reach which can be really exploited and then later on could be processed as a product? Product for healthy living and product for the treatment. Now, the medicine is very much specific to the individual. And depending upon the vat, pit, kaf, or you have three goda and nadi and all those things, probably you are supposed to ensure that what is required and in what quantity. So the second part, we can even think of how that individual data could be captured, and can we tailored our input services and product to the masses at large, including the rural masses, and make that stuff available to the individual on the basis of his health status. That will be another challenge which we can really capture through basically technology, and by employing a team of village volunteers. Those will be working for the different kind of the things. They will be working as a health volunteer. They will be working as a agriculture volunteers, where we would be capturing soil status. We will be capturing organic manure status and those kind of the things. So the similar volunteers would be then used to identify and have the health status of each individual. And then the backend engine can tailor what steps should be made available to that individual. That kind of the personalized service we are talking about. So, number one, where do we stand? I am very sure a lot of research must have been done. Hamare Dr. Umesh Shukla ji, he is himself is a PhD. So, aap logon se bahut sare logon ne PhD ki hogi, aur uski PhD medicinal plants ke upar bhi hogi, aur kahin bahar ke jo hai scholars ne bhi kuch PhDs ki hongi. So, wherever and whatever form the knowledge are available, can we really compile that knowledge, and can we really think of which medicine plants should be grown where? Because the moment you take the medicinal plant to the other region, its medicinal attributes, its medicinal benefits, its medicinal quality will not be of that level where it is having a right region, right climatic atmosphere. If it is really grown over there, we will have the best medicinal impact and effect of that medicine. So can we really calculate that whatever the stuff we are looking, is it available in that quantity, or we really go for a plantation of those medicinal plants, and where we would like to get involved that farmers and everybody, so that these medicinal plants, fruits plants, and other plants, floricultures, and everything could be put together, and probably a right number of the medicinal quantity or plants could be prepared, and then there could be the processing places where it can be converted into health living products and or healthy living products or treatment products, and then making it available to the person. Where we can use the village health volunteers who will be capturing the health status, and the expert brain, they can really assess things and can offer the medicine to the those person, and that medicine then through a kind of a chain supply mechanism could be made available to them. So one thing you must be appreciating, that the whole effort is that how we can really preserve the knowledge, how we can enrich the knowledge, whatever is missing. Probably it might be in possession of the some tribe, but many books have been written for the tribal medicines also. So even that knowledge could be accumulated. And then can we really make some assessment which we can be annually revising? And if we can calculate some kind of the formula for that, so that we can know that this much quantity of the medicine is required for healthy living. And then we can really make it sure that whatever the medicine, if it wo garmi ka yadi asar karti hai, garam asar karti hai, to kya usko counterbalance karne ke liye koi thandak wala product bhi saath mein dena hai. Those kind of the mix could be then created, and probably the technology can help out for the faster decision making. And by doing so, we can really provide a well-tailored, individualistic treatment with the Ayurveda. And if somewhere we feel that there's a need of allopathy, then allopathy doctors will also be, the technology will take them in, so that if it reaches to that emergency where we feel that some kind of the operation is necessary, some kind of the other interventions are necessary, that will also be, you know, become the part of the whole delivery. Now I would like to really listen all of you, that how can we really go in a collaborative format to really make that happen.
I think, sir, for today, we'll have to focus on certain points, and so that this kind of the meetings can be carried out for longer duration, and some concrete thoughts and ideas could be corroborated. So in this initial meeting, initial understanding between us, I just want to tell you, sir, that we are the institutionals. You must be knowing Pandit Kushilal Sharma Ayurveda Institution of Bhopal. And we are working for Ayurveda. And as you just pointed out, about the usefulness of medicinal plants, availability, and I think some voice issue is coming up.
And what to do? Audible. Dr. Sahib, you are perfectly audible. Absolutely no issue.
Fine. So there are many things actually to talk, but if you talk about Ayurveda, I would say that there are three main components where we should be known for, that our strength and potential lies on. Like, we are very strong on preventive medicine, and that doesn't only include certain drugs which are claimed to have some preventive potential actually from various diseases, but also various measures called as, you know, Swasth Vritta, that includes also Achar Rasayan and Rasayan treatment kind of things. Like, if you consume what he said, if you consume Rasayan drugs at certain age of your life, then the aging can be delayed. Highly acclaimed branch of medicine. And the second point, I would say that we have also the concept of personalized medicine, what you were referring to. We have individual kind of understanding about each and every patient's. Though there are various concepts like Tridosh, Saptadhatu, the disease diagnosis, its etiological factors, the premonitory symptoms, the pathogenesis of particular disease, the clinical manifestation of the disease, the complications, likely complications, the principles, the management of the disease, and finally the treatment. So all understanding, you can understand that 5,000 years ago we had. Unfortunately, because during the passage of the time, intervention of various, different the positions that happened actually during past 2,300 years, like Mughals and the intruders from the British and so on, we lost our actually the confidence during all these periods. And various other systems of medicine actually came into. And it was supposed that this is the only treatment modality that can be worked out, that is called as allopathy. And today we call this as modern system of medicine. But we had, sir, once again to tell you that we had preventive personalized medicine and predictive medicine concept is also very important, has very important place in Ayurveda. We can actually predict certain diseases which are supposed to take place during your life span. And we have detailed description of this kind of branch of medicine. As far you talked about the medicinal plants, I just want to tell you, sir, that this institute has a project which is running in four tribal districts of the state, namely Mandala, Didori, Anuppur, and Shahdol, where we are working on identifying certain medicinal plants which are otherwise not mentioned in Ayurvedic classics, or if at all they are mentioned for particular disease, they are the tribes are using for different ailments. So objective of this project is again to identify such medicine plants which are not available in Ayurvedic classics, though they have potential treatment benefits. And second, the medicinal plants that are available in Ayurvedic classics and indicated for certain diseases, they might be using for another, you know, indications, like we are using Arjun for hriday rog, cardiac illnesses, but they must be using for joint pain. So these two objectives we have, and actually carrying out our research work, having 600 lakhs project. And for your surprise, last 3 months, we actually posted 24 field investigators and we are working with them. Now, roughly we have identified around 55 medicinal plants, which are not mentioned in Ayurveda classics, though they are very much in practice among the tribes and also local Guniya and Baid. We are not 100% sure as of now that these have proven clinical efficacy. But yes, 55 medicinal plants around we are working on, which we have recently identified. Now, with the help of botanists, with the help of Drabhyaguna experts, with the help of pharmacognosists, we are going to have very clear understanding about the morphology of these medicinal plants. Then its pharmacological action on the basis of Ayurveda, like Rasgun, Viri, Vipak and Prabhav. And then we would also go on pharmaceutical analysis, pharmacognostical analysis, and then we'll go enter into experimental trials and finally clinical trials. If whatever has been claimed by the tribes, we find in our clinical study that and a proven track record, then probably we'll go for a patent, and also we will share the profits of patent with our tribes. This is you know, a study which may prove to be of very significant importance in future. About the medicinal plants, sir. At the same time, I also wish to tell you that Ayurveda is not just limited to the medicinal plants. It has huge minerals and also animal products. Not only medicinal plants, around 1,000 and more medicinal plants are described in Ayurvedic classics, but around 50,000, formulations there are actually in Ayurvedic compendia. And unfortunately, only around 5,000 formulations are in practice. So can you simply understand that only we are practicing only 10% of the Ayurveda today? And with the 10% of the practicing of Ayurveda, we are treating around 90% of the diseases. And the good thing, sir, that these 90% diseases are basically the diseases where there is no treatment plan available in modern medical science. And if at all these treatments are available, they are lifelong, empirical, and unfortunately full of side effects. And many times these are out of reach of common men of the country. Therefore, I think this is high time we should try to accelerate the use of Ayurveda with best of its form. And I'm sure that the people like you can contribute a lot, because you have, social dimensions, you have a backup plan, you have a support system. So I'm sure that you and the persons like you who have a very significant, status in the society probably can help a lot actually to regain its confidence and to substantiate the claims that have been made in Ayurveda. So for this, I don't think, sir, in initial meeting, the details of each and disease, maneuvering disease pattern and all that, the knowledge we have, at some point of time we can share. Also for this medicinal plant issues, which you are talking about, you must be knowing that at national level, there is National Medicinal Plants Board, NMPB. Which is looking after the issue that you have raised and we are concerned about. And all the states of the country have state medicinal plants board. Now this has come under the Department of Ayush of State. So I'm sure that these two organizations probably in future will deliver the goods, particularly preservation, conservation, and sustainable utilization of the medicinal plants. the point that you have raised is again very important. We have many agroclimatic zones around nine, and if any medicinal plants is being harvested, then it will soon disappear from the nature. So I think keeping in view the habitat, natural habitat of the particular medicinal plants, and on the basis of agroclimatic zones, we should start probably the agricultural work of the medicinal plants. Otherwise, soon many of the species will become endangered. This is cause of concern. We can focus actually on this, that endangered species can be preserved once again. And those who are in verge of extinction should again be brought to the notice of the people, those who are at higher level and authorities. For this moment, this is all, sir. We can offer many more things, but I think a different platform would be required. We will also come together in pure, mindset, where actually the main objective would be to serve the society with best of its hopes. Thank you.
Dr. Shukla, really, I'm grateful for the very important inputs, and a lot many inputs were absolutely a new information for me. And I will request you to kindly share the name and numbers of the person, those who are in Madhya Pradesh, they are having the responsibility about the medicinal plant. And then with the help of them, probably we can get the details about the other state also. And then we can really catalog and in which region or which zone, as you said that there are the nine zones, nine regions where different kind of the medicinal plants should be grown. And if we can have the region-wise list, and if we can really calculate somewhere that how much stuff, because if you talk of the only treatment, then you need very small quantity. But when that medicine you want to make the part of the healthy living, it means this ingredient will be consumed as a part of your food habits. Probably we would like to mix it with your atas and mix your sabjis as per, that shape and size of the that medicinal plant. Somewhere it can be taken as a pure joanna liquid or kada, those kind of the things that as now during the corona, people joanna really has gone for this gloe and those kind of kadas. And I recall that many patients who suffered from the cancer, they really they have gone for the wheatgrass juice, etc., because that could take care of. That could really take care of after effect of the chemotherapy or X-ray and all those kind of the negative effect. They were, to some extent, they were neutralized on from these kind of liquids which were prepared from, say, wheatgrass or from gloe or from something like that. Now, this knowledge, rather than sitting in an isolated format, can be really tabulated and for the healthy living. And since the people now they have gone on a ready-made format. यदि आप recall करिए कि बचपन में जब हम लोगों के घरों में आचार पापा अचार पापड़ और जाने कितनी कितनी चीजें जो बनती थी बढ़िया हम उसको बड़े चाव से खाते थे और वो बड़ी हेल्दी रहती थी क्योंकि उसमें तेल वेल का कम यूज होता था उनको जो है ना सन में सुखाते थे और सन का भी कुछ पॉजिटिव उसमें मेरे ख्याल से इफेक्ट आता होगा. अब जो है ओवर द पीरियड हम जो ज्वाइंट फैमिली से न्यूक्लियर फैमिली पे चले गए हैं तो हमारी जो बहुत सारी कैपेबिलिटीज थी जहां पे हम इन सब चीजों को करने के लिए हमारे पास टाइम एनर्जी और वो रहता था अब वो चीजें गायब हो गई हैं. अब इवन हम लोग पापड़ अचार वगैरह भी हमको बाजार से खरीदना पड़ता है. तो नॉलेज बांटने से काम नहीं पड़ेगा. यदि मान लो लोग बाग अपने घर पे बना सकते तो हमने नॉलेज भी बांट दिया. यदि वो नहीं बना सकते हैं तो उसको प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म में भी क्रिएट करके मेकिंग यूज ऑफ द चैन सप्लाई लेट इट बी मेड अवेलेबल टू देम एंड लेट इट बिकम ए पार्ट ऑफ द देयर एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन इन वेरियस फॉर्मेट्स. कुछ सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करने में करेंगे, कुछ प्रोसेसिंग में करेंगे, कुछ जो है ना उसको चीजों को बनाने में करेंगे. एंड हम जो है ना उसमें एक एलिमेंट और लाना चाहते हैं जो वैल्यू सिस्टम का हमने बीच में कहा था कि चाहे वो फार्मर हो चाहे वो ट्राइबल हो वो चीजों में मिलावट करके, बदमाशी करके और धोखा देके गड़बड़ी ना कर पाए, ये हम टेक्नोलॉजी के माध्यम से सुनिश्चित करें। क्योंकि यदि हम इंडिया में इस डायमेंशन पे काम नहीं करेंगे तो वो आपके पूरे सिस्टम को ध्वस्त कर देगा। क्योंकि मालूम पड़ा कि आपका आयुर्वेदा तो बहुत अच्छा है, आपका जो मेडिसिन आप कह रहे हैं वो भी बहुत अच्छा है, लेकिन सामने वाले को जो दिया गया है वो मेडिसिन वो है ही नहीं, वो तो कोई उसका जो है ना सिमिलर लुकिंग प्रोडक्ट है। अभी आपने देखा होगा कि यूपी में एक आरएसएस के ही बड़े कार्यकर्ता पकड़े गए हैं जो कि गधों की लीद को जो है वो खाने के मसालों में यूज कर रहे थे। तो जब पुलिस को किसी ने इन्फॉर्मेशन दी तो उन्होंने सर्च की तो उन्होंने कहा कि हाँ घोड़े गधों की लीद तो कहीं दिख ही नहीं रही है। तो मालूम पड़ा कि वो लीद साहब उन महोदय के पास जा रही थी एंड फाइनली उनके यहाँ पे अभी बड़ा रेड हुआ है और ही इज अंडर इंटेंस इंट्रोगेशन ऑफ द पुलिस। सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग कि लोगों की लालच और चाहे वो किसी भी तरीके, चाहे फार्मर्स हों चाहे ट्राइबल्स हों, आजकल हम सब लोग जो है ना धन को इजी तरीके से पाना चाहते हैं, हम सब लोग लालच में जो है ना कहीं लिप्त हो गए हैं। तो ये व्यक्तिगत लालच जो है क्वालिटी से कंप्रोमाइज ना कर पाए, चाहे वो कोई भी क्यों ना हो। और जैसे कि हम पुलिस में इविडेंस को कैप्चर करते हैं, ऐसे ही हम वहां पे उसकी ट्रांसपेरेंसली ये कैप्चर करने की कोशिश करेंगे कि नोबडी शुड बी इन पोजीशन टू प्ले गेम्स विद द क्वालिटी, चाहे वो कोई भी क्यों ना हो। एंड वी विल नॉट अलाउ हिम टू टेक द एडवांटेज ऑफ हिज लेवल के भाई बेचारा फार्मर अच्छा काम करने के लिए हो, बेचारा फार्मर जो है ना गड़बड़ी करने के लिए नहीं होना चाहिए। एंड वी विश दैट कि इनकी सैपलिंग बनाई जाए और जो है देन हमारा जो नेटवर्क है उस नेटवर्क का यूज करके उस जगह पे हम उस क्वांटिटी में उस चीज को जो है मेडिसिनल प्लांट को बनाए और उस मेडिसिनल प्लांट में कुछ पार्ट हम जो है काउ के कंजम्पशन के लिए यूज करें और हनी का भी जो है ना जो बी कीपिंग का भी यदि हम उन स्पेशलाइज पार्क में यूज करेंगे। तो जैसे कहते हैं कि जो चीज खाई जाती है उसका स्वभाव जो है उसके सभी जो है ना बॉडी लिक्विड्स में आता है, जैसे मिल्क में विशेष तौर पे आता है। तो अपन कहते हैं कि जो माँ बनने वाली है उसको अच्छा खाना दीजिए जिससे कि उसका दूध जो है ना एनरिच रहे। तो अभी हमारी जो गायें हैं वो कचरे के घूर पे बैठती हैं, खराब खराब चीजें खाती हैं, उनको जो पेस्टिसाइड और उससे रिलेटेड चीजें मिलती हैं उन्हीं को वो ही खा रहे हैं। तो उनके मिल्क में भी वो चीज जा रही है, हनी में भी वो चीज जा रही है। Probably once we cater for this kind of the medicinal parks, then and we can say ki few parks may be dedicated for the few plants where we can even go for ke wahan pe hum cattle ki feed bhi jo hai na unhi plants se dein, jisse ki wo medicine ki value na keval jo hai na dawaon mein jaye but yadi wo milk mein bhi chali jaye aur us milk ke madhyam se if we can have that milk for say blood pressure, milk for this purpose, milk for that purpose, या हनी फॉर दिस पर्पज और हनी फॉर दैट पर्पज। अभी हनी के साथ भी प्रॉब्लम ये हो रही है कि जो अच्छे ब्रांड भी हैं वो भी नकली दवा नकली जो है ना हनी बेच रहे हैं, क्योंकि उतनी क्वांटिटी में जितना जरूरत है उतनी हनी पैदा ही नहीं हो पा रही है। तो वो भी जो है ना शक्कर वक्कर मिला मिलू के कुछ भी उल्टा सीधा करके उस तरीके का प्रोडक्ट जो है, अच्छी रेपुटेड कंपनी भी शायद उस तरीके के गड़बड़ियों में शायद मजबूरी में कर रही होंगी लेकिन कर रही हैं। तो क्या हम ये असेस करें कि हमें यदि अज्यूम कर ले हम काल्पनिक ढंग से कि हमारी पूरी पॉपुलेशन जो है इन दो प्रोडक्ट जो है मिल्क को और हनी को एज ए पार्ट ऑफ जो है ना देयर हेल्दी लिविंग यदि अपन करें तो कितने हमको पास हमको सेहत की जरूरत पड़ेगी और क्या उतनी सेहत पैदा हो रही है। यदि नहीं हो रही है तो वो सेहत जो है ना पैदा करने का वो बनाया जाए एंड देन जो है इट कैन बी रियली मेड अवेलेबल। और इस तरीके की यदि सेहत होगी जो कि मेडिसिनल न्यूट्रिशनल एंड मेडिसिनल इम्पैक्ट भी रखेगी या उस तरीके का डिफरेंशिएशन भी रखेगी तो इसका इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे बहुत हाई डिमांड होगी जिसको हम बहुत ही निस प्राइस पर बेच सकेंगे, जिससे कि रूरल वेल्थ और रूरल इकोनॉमी में एक बहुत सकारात्मक असर आ पाएगा। तो हमारी जो अभी प्रेजेंट डिपेंडेंसी जो रूरल इकोनॉमी की ऑन एग्रीकल्चर है दैट कैन बी रियली देन कन्वर्टेड इनटू द सेल सर्विसेज, कन्वर्टेड इनटू द वेरियस काइंड ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन विच कुड बी रिलेटेड टू द प्रोसेसिंग विच कुड बी रिलेटेड टू द सर्विसेज एंड वी कैन रियली मल्टीप्लाई रूरल इनकम maybe the 3, 4, or 5-fold, that kind of the multiplication would be doable, where we can bring the cross subsidy by ensuring some supply in international market also. If that happens, then it will be great. So I will request whether you would like, any one of you would like to add what Dr. Umesh Shukla sir has said, though really he covered the subject so well, probably leaving little less scope for you people. But still, Johanna, whatever little you would like to add, please add fast, then we will decide that how we would like to really take it forward, taking the whatever the wisdom has been given by Dr. Umesh Shukla.
विवेक आपको कुछ बोलना है बोलिए. संजय जी आप देखिए, पुनीत आप.
सर आई थिंक दैट सच मोर सेशंस आर नीडेड एंड वी मस्ट एड्रेस वन इशू एट अ टाइम इन अ सेशन सर. इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक जहां तक सर ने बात बताई. अनदर पॉइंट विच इज द प्राइम ऑफ आयुर्वेदा इज द प्रकृति परीक्षण. Where we individualize the prakriti of a particular person and then the management can be done accordingly. And rest of the things are already being well said by sir. So we can continue in further sessions for the same, sir.
Puneet, do you want to say something?
Yes, sir. Next time
you're not audible. You're not audible. Sanjay, Dr. Sanjay ji, aap kuch kehna chahenge? So for today, I think, sir,
all the things, nadi is one among the important factor for the human being, and it should be incorporated in the next.
ठीक है. तो सर, I think आज के लिए आपका ये initiative जो था वो एक basic हमारे बीच में थोड़ी सी चर्चा हो गई, और future में हम कुछ जैसा विवेक ने suggest किया कुछ पॉइंट्स ले करके बात करेंगे तो बेहतर होगा सर, और उससे सो दैट हम कुछ कंक्लूड कर पाएंगे, शायद कोई रोड मैप प्लान कर पाएंगे. आप देखें सर, हम लोगों की जो व्यस्तताएं हैं वो कुछ इस समय एक तो रूटीन हॉस्पिटल रन करने में, टीचिंग रिसर्च सारी चीज़ों में लगी हुई हैं, प्लस जो थर्ड वेव है उसकी प्रिपेयर्डनेस में भी लगी हुई हैं. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल सर, मुझे इमीडिएट अभी आई हैव टू लीव इमीडिएटली टू डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ आयुष सो दैट आई कैन मीट टू पीएस. तो अभी सर मैं आपसे क्षमा भी चाहूंगा, और नेक्स्ट के लिए जब भी आप कहेंगे तो विल बी देयर टू हैव एनी.
ओके, आई विल टेक 1 मिनट टू समराइज इट. नंबर 1, व्हाट यू सेड दैट अबाउट द एमपी मेडिसिनल प्लांट, देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर बोर्ड और कमेटी. आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू टू, वी विल बी हैविंग वन डेडिकेटेड सेशन विद देम. And I would like, as a my representative, you should be present in that session also. And we can really schedule it as per your convenience. Because I really feel that there's a too much demand on you. And we are in a very critical hour. And I am of the very strong view that I don't know whether you can really suggest to with that boldness. I am of the firm view that corona is being not being handled properly. So we will discuss about that a little separately. And I am also of the very firm opinion that we are ill, Johanna, prepared to really allow our economy to suffer that way. Probably we can handle this corona, third wave or fourth wave and 10th wave also, with making use of your Ayurveda, making use of your lemon juice. Because I concluded that no coronavirus, neither beta variety nor delta variety and all future variety cannot really face an infant, and they will die in front of the lemon juice. That I have proven scientifically through the RT-PCR test. And with the lemon juice is having pH value 2, It is not only that destroying outer membrane of the coronavirus, but it is even destroying the RNA structure of the coronavirus. So any virus, forget about the corona, that cannot withstand your lemon juice. And I suggest if any of the corona patients coming to you, you please start doing that as an additionality. I am very sure.
Sir,
not even a single death will take place. I take a guarantee that not even a single death will take place.
I just got your point. And also, I have been experiencing various, you know, social media messages in the name of you saying that, claiming and all. And sir, my
I have written four letters to the Prime Minister. I have written three letters to ICMR also.
Serious issue hai. बहुत सीरियस इशू है एंड वॉट एवर यू आर क्लेमिंग. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है सर कि एक ऐसी लैब, फॉर एग्जांपल यहाँ पर भोपाल में आईसर है और दूसरा एक यहाँ पर बहुत अच्छी लैब है जो बहुत ज्यादा नहीं जानी जा रही पर आप जानते होंगे डेफिनेटली, जो कि ये जो एनिमल लैब है, एनिमल से रिलेटेड लैब है और बहुत हाईली एडवांस्ड लैब है. इन लोगों से अगर आप संपर्क करें सर, तो ह्यूमन में आने के पहले ये वाला जो आपका कॉन्सेप्ट है तो उसको सीधे आप लैब में उसकी एंटीवायरल एक्टिविटीज पर आप काम कर सकते हैं. इन दो लोगों से आप संपर्क करें.
प्लीज शेयर देयर नेम एंड नंबर्स टू मी सेपरेटली एंड आई विल सर्टेनली कांटेक्ट देम. And basically, whatever I am suggesting, I have already tested it on the laboratory format, because in RT-PCR test, the positive sample then was subjected by the traces of the lemon juice. And that trace of the lemon juice was in position to destroy the outer membrane as well as the RNA structure. And we have tried this almost on 600 or very deadly patients. And all of them, they could be come out of it. The last person who came out of it, she was a Muslim lady of the 90 year of the age, and she was not cooperative also. And one of our volunteer, Ritesh, he basically pursued her and convinced her. And it took him 2 days. And she was having the oxygen saturation level of the 57%. The next day, he could take it to the 70, 75, and third day, it came to the 98%. So that lady certainly was going to die. She was just saved through the lemon therapy and kala therapy. So it is question of really, I think if people can come forward and playing a little boldly, if we can really do that, it will be a great service. My claim was this, that within 6 days, we can make this country corona free. So no corona will be existing in any human body, and no corona would be existing in any environment also.
आपके इंफॉर्मेशन के लिए मैं बताऊं कि स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ने, मध्य प्रदेश सरकार ने, आत्मनिर्भर मध्य प्रदेश के अंतर्गत 4.2 आउटकम में ये एक टास्क फोर्स उन्होंने बनाया है एंड आई एम हेडिंग दैट टास्क फोर्स. उसमें उसका आइडिया यही है कि जितनी भी मेडिकल नॉलेज है, एलोपैथी, आयुर्वेदा, होम्योपैथी, आरएनए मेडिसिन, दे कैन कम फॉरवर्ड एंड प्रेजेंट देयर व्हाटएवर दे हैव डन, और उनको हम डॉक्यूमेंट करें और उस पूरे नॉलेज को करने की कोशिश करें सर. तो आई एम श्योर कि ये परिस्थितियों में आने वाले समय में हम आपको मौका देंगे कि आप अपना पूरा प्रेजेंटेशन दें, जो भी आपके पास डेटा वगैरह, तो वो सही प्लेटफॉर्म होगा जहां लोग सुन पाएंगे आपको और उसके पास.
वी विल डू दैट, वी विल सर्टेनली डू दैट. एंड बेसिकली वी वुड लाइक टू टेक द फर्दर हेल्प दैट सिंस द फ्यू एट लीस्ट फ्यू पेशेंट मस्ट बी कमिंग टू द योर सेंटर्स आल्सो, यू कैन आल्सो जाना देन मेक यूज ऑन देम. And I think everything should be done very scientifically, and we should be ready to publish it as a research paper. Let's not allow that some pathy to dominate to the detriment of the patient. In case of the coronaviral, you are giving deadly antibiotics, which are responsible for the deadly side effect. Many deaths could be attributed, including the suicide, to that medicine. And basically, by giving a steroid, we are really taking our patient to that situation when we are leaving everything to the corona. So we will have a separate session on the corona. Let's not really make it a corona session. Let's go back to the original things. Let's recapitulate. Number one, I am ready to your proposition that I can give a detailed presentation in which we will talk with the facts and figures. We will talk that how exactly we arrived on our conclusions. And it was also a journey. Earlier, I was just pleading to the Prime Minister and suggesting you please do that way. And when we thought nothing is happening, then we did so. We will be making a full-fledged presentation on your platform. And then there, after deliberation, we can say that how this thing can be further codified, further scientifically could be verified in the best Johanna way, which is acceptable to the world and can be become the torch wearer for the world in this way. Let the vested interest group, those who are minting money out of it, they should not mint the money and they should not roost the, or they must not dominate the scene. मतलब वो बदमाशी भी करें, मकारी भी करें, पैसा भी खा जो है ना बेचारे जो है ना लोग और उनके लोग भी मर जाएं और इसके बाद वो अपने आप को महान भी कहते रहें, ये मेरे ख्याल से बहुत हो गया है। अब इसको यदि आपका जो वो प्लेटफॉर्म, इफ दैट कुड रियली प्रोवाइड ए सॉलिड प्लेटफॉर्म, आई थिंक वी विल बी डूइंग अ ग्रेट फेवर टू दिस नेशन, नंबर वन। नंबर टू, प्लीज शेयर द कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बोर्ड विच यू आर टॉकिंग, सो वी विल हैव ए सेशन विद देम एंड वी विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लोर वेयर आर दे and how we can pitch in and we can help them. That is the second we can do. Third part, I think I will again look for you, that how we can really do the processing part of it. So if we are, say, creating or understanding is a global demand, we can really create a few industries, rural industries, where that processing is doable and at the local level, because somewhere in my mind, we do not want it to be urban centric thing only. Let it be go in the rural areas and somewhere it could become the part of the rural employment generation. Somewhere that is in my back of the mind. So whether we are going for the medicinal plantation, whether we are going for the beekeeping, or whether we are going that differentiated milk, at the back of my mind, or whether we are talking of the organic manure and lot many things, because they are not a part of Ayurvedic, that's why we are not discussing. But otherwise, we are having n number of the things which we are discussing with the agriculture scientists, we are discussing with the other things, and we intend to create a techno-driven platform where we should be in position to make its delivery possible to the public as a product or service. We refuse to impart knowledge, because for imparting the knowledge, you have to have the trust, you have to think this, that. And basically, we can have the research so that whatever we should talk, that should not be faith-driven. That should be largely experience, and it should be a proven scientific of validation. So whatever we will be doing, whether it is written in Charak Sangha, whether it is written somewhere else, let that be proven to the society, to the world at large, by making use of the best tool, best research methodology acceptable to them. अब जैसे एक डॉक्टर ने मुझसे कहा कि सर हम जो है जो आपका नींबू का रस है इसके मॉलिक्यूल निकाल रहे हैं और बहुत सारे काम कर रहे हैं. आई सेड कि आप मॉलिक्यूल निकालने में क्यों लग रहे हैं? यू टेस्ट दिस वेदर इट इज फंक्शनिंग और नॉट. यदि आप मॉलिक्यूल निकाल के दवा बनाएंगे और महंगी दवा को बेचेंगे तो इससे कोई भला तो भारत का होने वाला नहीं है. आपका भला हो जाएगा लेकिन भारत का भला नहीं होगा. तो यदि हमारा कोई प्रोडक्ट जो है ना उसके मॉलिक्यूल बनाकर उसको केमिकली हम क्यों बनाए? लेट इट गो इन आयुर्वेदिक फॉर्मा विच इज विल नॉट बी हैविंग एनी साइड इफेक्ट. तो हम लोगों को उनके नॉलेज को पर्सनल जो है बेनिफिट का साधन नहीं बनने देंगे, उनको जो है ना सोसाइटी को हार्म. अब ये बताइए, जहां ये एलोपैथी आई है वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड से, वहां आई हैड बीन टू द वेरियस कंट्रीज एंड वन ऑफ माय ऑफिसर, वन ऑफ द ऑफिसर फ्रॉम भूटान, ही वाज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ माय टीम एंड ही सफर्ड एंड ही फेल डाउन एंड वी वर ऑल जो है ना शॉक्ड एंड वी इमीडिएटली वेंट फॉर एमआरआई एटसेट्रा. टिल अवर डिपार्चर दे हैव नॉट गिवन एनी एंटीबायोटिक और एनी मेडिसिन टू दैट पर्सन. सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गिव द एंटीबायोटिक एंड हियर दे आर गिविंग एज ए एंटीबायोटिक एज ए पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोटोकॉल. आपको खांसी हो जाएगी वो आपको एंटीबायोटिक दे देंगे, बिना एंटीबायोटिक के उनके काम ही नहीं चलता है. सो दे आर डिस्ट्रॉइंग अवर सिस्टम एंड वाई गिविंग एंटीबायोटिक यू आर किलिंग माई फ्रेंडली बैक्टीरिया. ये बात मालूम नहीं आप लोग जो है ना कैसे जो है ना उनको चैलेंज नहीं कर पाते. व्हाट इज दिस नॉनसेंस हैपनिंग. तो समवेयर अब हम जो है ना किसी दूसरे की लाइन छोटा नहीं करना चाहते. वी वांट कि हमारा जो नॉलेज है, हमारा जो वो चीज है, वो ना केवल ट्रीटमेंट करेगी बल्कि हम जो है ना लोगों को बीमार ही नहीं होने देंगे. तो हम केवल ट्रीटमेंट फोकस नहीं होंगे, हम जो है हेल्दी लिविंग फोकस होंगे. और हेल्दी लिविंग फोकस में जो डॉक्टर विवेक शर्मा ने बात कही है, हाउ टू कैप्चर दैट इंडिविजुअल स्टेटस एंड उसको कैप्चरिंग के लिए हम क्या डिवाइसेस बना सकते हैं जो कम पढ़े लिखे लोग जो है उनका यूज करके उस स्टेटस को कैप्चर कर सके. आई वाज डिस्कसिंग विद सम साइंटिस्ट कि क्या जैसे अभी अपन ब्लड प्रेशर का करते हैं क्या हम कुछ सेंसर नहीं बना सकते हैं जिससे कि हम बात पे तो कफ को भी मेजर कर ले. आई थिंक इट इज डूएबल. तो अब इसमें मैं तो इवन रिसर्च और साइंस को भी प्रमोट कर रहा हूँ. आई एम वर्किंग विद 53 यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड आई हैव टेकन ए प्लेस के हम अपने देश को ट्रांसफॉर्म करके मानेंगे चाहे उसके लिए हमें कितनी भी उठापटक क्यों ना करना पड़े. एंड हेल्थ इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड बिकॉज हेल्थ एंड वेल्थ इज रिलेटेड. और हेल्थ के साथ यदि वेल्थ भी आ जाए इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ गेनिंग हेल्थ देन इट विल बी समथिंग ग्रेट फॉर द अवर स्पेशली अवर रूरल इंडिया. और आई वेरी स्ट्रांगली फील कि जो है ना जो गाय वाय और जो है ना ये सब वाई दे शुड नॉट गो इन द फॉरेस्ट एरिया इन द जंगल एरिया जहाँ उनको बेस्ट जो है ना खाने को मिले एंड देन जो है ना मिल्क एंड प्रोसेस थिंग्स कैन फ्लो टू द नेबरिंग अर्बन सेंटर. एंड जो दूध में भी जो है ना ये लोग कह के भी जो है ना दे आर मिक्सिंग द पाउडर एंड देन मैनी पाउडर इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द अमेरिका विच इज ऑफ द केमिकल ऑरिजन एंड इट इज हाईली रिस्की. बट आई डोंट नो हम लोग सब लोग जो है इतने मौनवे धारण कर लिए हैं या इन शक्तियों के सामने हम लोग इतने कमजोर हो गए हैं कि हम अपने ही देश में अच्छी बात नहीं कह पाते हैं, अच्छा काम नहीं कर पाते हैं, अच्छा प्रोडक्ट नहीं ला पाते हैं. हम इतने सारे जो है ना लोगों से जो है ना इस तरीके के लोगों से घिरे हुए हैं. तो आई फील के सेकेंड डायमेंशन में हम ये बात देखने की कोशिश करें कि हाउ दिस कैप्चरिंग ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल डाटा कुड बी यूज थ्रू द सेंसर्स एंड दिस डाटा कुड बी कैप्चुलेटेड at a given interval, maybe 6 monthly or maybe annually, and we can provide the healthy living products as well as the health or as well as the treatment by making use of these village volunteers. For doing their service, they will be getting instantaneously a revenue stream also. And that sum total of that revenue stream will be probably more than what they can earn from their agriculture employment. So, though they will be doing agriculture things also, but at the same time they will do this additional work also, and whatever they will be doing, they will be getting a revenue stream. So second part could be this. Third part could be that your so much of the work which has been done by you, how we can capsulate it and really translate through the mechanism so that it is available to the people, and not only to the people, those who are really coming to the Ayurveda. It is an era of marketing. Let's reach out to the people ke sahab jo hai na this is much better. Aap ye khanse ki jo hai na ye goliyan kyon kha rahe hain, antibiotic kyon kha rahe hain, uski jagah pe ye khaiye, aapko probably it will be better. So with these words, I think you can really request your team to prepare a report what we can do together in the light of the discussion we held, and then we will we will really have other sessions, and those sessions, as Dr. Vivek Sharma said, that we can have more focus and they will be limited to one topic where we can deliberate and we can even sit together and we can really demarcate how jo hai na these things could be converted into the product and services and available in the easy format at the rarest or the jo na kehna chahiye remotest of the rural areas, forget about the urban centers. So I hope these points which I have requested, I think Dr. Omesh Shuklaji would like to say a few words, and then I will request him that we will close the session and he may proceed for his meeting.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, it's okay. Thank you so much. We'll continue to talk, sir. Thank you.
Right. Thank you. Thanks a lot for Johanna really making it possible at a very short span. I am really grateful to you. I am grateful to your team. I am very sure this will be a opening things, and we will be taking this journey forward. Thanks a lot.